You might have come across this story earlier this week, Groupon's do or die moment. And it's talking about this startup, Groupon. The daily coupon website. It's expanding. It's changing its business model. It's been called the fastest growing startup in history. It's expecting sales to top $3 billion this year. Not bad for a company that is 2 years old. Now, investors have made millions on startups like Groupon, and there are ways that you can get in on the action as well. The question is, should you? And if you should, how do you do it? So I want to have that discussion with Matt McCall. He's the president of Penn Financial Group. Matt, you get all this vibe about these new companies, these newly public companies and IPOs. How does the average person get involved in this, and should they?
Well, first of all, should they? It's a real big question,
right?
Because you take a lot of risk, because a lot of these companies, obviously, as you mentioned, aren't publicly traded. So it's very difficult, first of all, to get shares to invest in these companies. Second of all, there's not a lot of information out there about these companies before they go public. And even more importantly, a lot of times you can actually get into this company, but your money's tied up for years. You
right.
can't sell it tomorrow like you can sell a normal stock.
So
That's
you look
important.
At a company Facebook or Groupon, and if there's an IPO, an initial public offering, usually the people who get those first shares are investment houses and they're good clients, right?
Exactly.
So generally, a guy like me is not going to get stock on the first day unless I buy it on the open market. Is that wise?
No, that's not wise, because what happens is typically they price an IPO at a certain price. Let's say it's $10 per share.
Yeah.
That stock may open that first day of trading at $20 a share.
Right.
So you're paying twice as much as the person who bought the day before the pre-IPO.
Which was a private sale. You couldn't have gotten into
that. You couldn't have gotten in. I mean,
yeah.
ultra wealthy, like you said, investment banks can get in.
Yeah.
So typically what you want to do is wait a few weeks and watch the action. Zipcar, for example. A lot of people know Zipcar.
Yeah.
Just went public in the last couple
yes.
of weeks. Stock came up high 20s. Fell to the low 20s in a matter of days.
Right.
But I had a lot of individual investors call me that day that wanted to get in, buying at the high, right
off
the bat.
But even though it fell, bottom line is if you were one of those pre-investors, one of the smart money that you and I can't be, you've still probably made money on that.
Yes, you're still up money right now. But keep in mind, a lot of people that get in pre-IPO
yeah.
can't sell for the first six
right.
months as well.
Right.
So they're kind of locked up. There's a lot of risk that goes along with that.
Okay. And of course, I mean, one example is a company like Google where that would have made sense to buy on the first day. But how do you know? When do you know when it's time to get into a new company?
Sure.
Because while all this nonsense about the first few days or the first few weeks or first few months is absolutely true, what if I think Groupon's a great company or Facebook is a great company when it goes public one day? When should I invest?
Well, what I do typically is to take a look. Zipcar is a great example. You take that and you compare it to similar companies and see how it's valued.
Yeah.
For example, let's take Hertz.
Yeah.
Hertz is trying to become the next Zipcar. So
right.
you compare those two companies and say to yourself, well, Zipcar just reported earnings this week. They're losing 95 cents a share in one quarter. Is now the time to jump in? Probably not. So you look for a price, whether it be $18 or $19 a share, and be patient. Let it come to you
okay.
and buy at that price.
That's a very good point. Be patient. Let the stock price come to you. Is there a way to invest in startups using either an exchange-traded fund or a mutual fund where somebody else does the hard work for you?
Well, what there is the PowerShares Private Equity Exchange-Traded
okay.
Fund. So what that does, invest in a basket of private equity companies, and what they do, take a step further, they own a lot of these companies that are private and they'll eventually take them public. So you're buying into a basket of companies that are publicly traded, and within there they own another basket of companies that are privately traded. So it's one way for the investor to get in there. And what's nice, over the last 12 months, this is actually up 23%,
right.
blowing the doors off, and it pays a 4.6% dividend on top
okay,
of that.
Okay, so that if you are dying to invest in a company before it's a public company, that's your way to do it.
That's your only way for the average investor. Unless
sure.
you're sitting on hundreds of millions of dollars, then you can call your broker and get into Groupon right now.
Probably. Okay, the private PowerShares Private Equity ETF is PSP. Matt McCall, president of Penn Financial Group. Always great to have you on
Thank
the
you.
Show. Thank you.